Welcome to College Smart Radio, helping you bring into focus the true cost of college and how to tackle the runaway cost of financing a college education. College Smart Radio is hosted by Beatrice Schultz, a certified financial planner and founder of Westface College Planning. Now, here's your host for College Smart Radio, Beatrice Schultz.
Welcome to College Smart Radio. Student loans have become an indispensable tool for families trying to pay the soaring cost of higher education, which at some private colleges and universities tops $60,000 a year. There are government student loans available, but many students need to borrow more than is available from the government. On today's College Smart Radio program, we're going to discuss private student loans as a source to help you navigate the borrowing options. Hi, I'm Beatrice Schultz. Welcome to our weekly show, College Smart Radio, where we help you tackle the runaway costs of a college education. Our show is about bringing up-to-date and practical advice to parents who are dealing with the cost of a college education for their kids. College is expensive and getting more so each year. With a private school costing up to $60,000 or more than $60,000 a year, a UC costing close to $35,000, and a California State University running $25,000 when you look at the total cost of attendance, parents need more help than ever. We bring you that help by sharing ways to pay less, tapping into financial aid, and prioritizing your source of funds to make sure you get through the most expensive years of your life. Based on my own education and experience, I share my insights with you week in and week out. I hold a Bachelor of Science degree in Chemical Engineering and a Master's degree in International Business. I'm a CFP, a Certified Financial Planner, and the owner of the San Carlos-based college planning business, Westface College Planning. We host workshops on college planning and consult with parents on a daily basis. And in addition to my insights, I bring in experts in many areas of the college process, from counselors, college administrators, financial professionals, parents, and even students. You'll learn firsthand the ins and outs of how to pay for college and survive financially. In addition to our show, you can also find lots of powerful information on our collegesmartradio.com and westfacecollegeplanning.com websites. We have many articles that I've authored with up-to-date information on navigating the waters of paying for runaway costs of college. We have a monthly e-newsletter full of content about college planning, and we also have posted a glossary of key terms used in the world of college planning. And we have a link to our free community parent workshops, which I host live as well as via webinar, to teach parents about how to pay for college and how the financial aid system really works. Let's get into today's show. When borrowing for college, it's important to weigh all your student loan options. American students took out twice the value of student loans in 2011, which is $112 billion, as they did a decade before in 2001. So twice the amount in 10 years students are taking out in debt after adjusting for inflation. Although the percentage of parents, students who borrow does decrease as family income rises, students from all income groups are taking out student loans. And studies show that students, not surprisingly, who attend institutions with a higher price of attendance are more likely to borrow more than those who attend institutions with a lower price of attendance. So on average, at public four-year institutions, 60% of graduating seniors today have some education debt. Of these borrowers, one-half have at least $15,000 in student loans, about a quarter have at least $23,000 in student loans, and 10% have student debts of $33,000 or more. The number is higher at private, nonprofit four-year institutions, where over 75% of graduating seniors have some kind of education debt. And of those borrowers, the numbers are higher, and 10% of them have student debt of $40,000 or more. And we definitely hear about students that have $50,000, $60,000, $70,000, $80,000, worth of debt when they graduate. These numbers are increasing every year. So how does a student or family navigate the borrowing options? On today's College Smart Radio show, we'll be discussing how to shop and choose the best student loan for your student. Let's start by defining student loans. The types of student loans available fall into two pretty broad categories: federal loans, direct loans made directly by the government, and private loans. I mean, those are really the two big groups, which are essentially, private loans are essentially the same as any other consumer loan from a bank or other company. The interest rate paid by students on direct loans, or as they're known, Stafford direct loans, is fixed. The interest rate is fixed and set by Congress. By contrast, private loans have a huge range of different terms: interest rates, both fixed and variable, cosign requirements, and possible prepayment penalties and fees. You'll need to navigate the options and understand the rules of a private student loan in the same ways you would any other consumer loan that you take out. But let's start with government loans. The current rate for government-subsidized student loans was set by Democrats in 2007 through legislation that temporarily reduced the interest rates for low- and middle-income undergraduates to receive them. What does that mean? Well, not everyone qualifies for the low rate that was dropped in 2007, but that rate's 3.4%. It was 6.8%. It was scheduled to revert to 6.8% in July of 2012, but Congress intervened, so the government direct Stafford loan interest rate has been extended at 3.4%. Remember from previous shows, a subsidized loan means that the interest is paid by the government until graduation for any student enrolled at least half time. So if you're getting lost with any of these terms like subsidized loans, make sure you print out or bring up on your tablet or glossary of college planning terms for reference during the show. The glossary is available at collegesmartradio.com. It's complicated, and knowing the terms, without knowing the terms, it's easy to get lost. The subsidized loan rate of 3.4% is a nice low rate for student loans and is the most preferred loan that I see in the marketplace today. Unfortunately, in order to qualify for this preferred subsidized government loan, you need to prove that you are the most needy at the college you're attending. Then, if you do qualify for the subsidized loan, the most that will be loaned is $3,000 per year. With college costing $20,000 to $65,000 a year, most families are going to need more. Low-income families may also qualify for a Perkins loan, which is also a subsidized loan and had a current and has a current fixed interest rate of 5%. The maximum Perkins loan is only $4,000, and this is only available to the lowest income families. The government also offers a Stafford Direct unsubsidized loan, and these are available to most students, whether you have a need or not. The current rate for an unsubsidized loan is a fixed rate of 6.8%, but the maximum that a student can borrow for their freshman year in total Stafford loans is $5,500. Unfortunately, many students need to borrow more. After exhausting the government student loan sources, often families default to a PLUS loan. A PLUS, or P-L-U-S, loan stands for a parent loan for undergraduate students. And by definition, it is a student loan offered to parents of students enrolled in college. PLUS loans are guaranteed by the government and do feature a fixed interest rate, but the interest rate can vary between the mid-sevens to the high eights, and the rates are based on a parent's credit score. When families I work with are considering taking out more loans than the Stafford $5,500 available to a freshman, I always suggest that they shop around before choosing a PLUS loan. You can find many competitive private loans with better terms than the PLUS loan, so it pays to shop around. And many families graduate and students graduate with PLUS loans that are high rates, and they've sometimes spent more money than they need to. But buyer beware. Make sure you know all the factors and terms of the loans that you're considering. And you do need to do your own, you do need to understand what these terms are for private loans. So those factors are going to include: what's the lender's reputation? What are the terms of the loan? Like, what's the interest rate? Is it variable or fixed? Do you need a cosigner? Will you be offered a lower rate if you do have a cosigner? When will the cosigner be removed from the loan? What are the repayment terms? Can you defer payment until after your student graduates, or do you need to start repayment 60 days after the loan's disbursed? Are there any prepayment penalties? Are there discounts if you set up an automatic repayment plan, which is common with most private loans? And the most important factor, do not borrow more than you need. Remember this tip: live like a student while you're a student, so you will not need to live like a student for the rest of your life. So, how does a student or parent shop around for the right loan for them? You can search the internet for student loans, and many private lenders will show up to the table. There are also some sites that allow you to search across multiple private lenders at one time. My guest in the studio today will be sharing some information with us on the private student loan marketplace designed for you to compare private loans. Lloyd Lyons is the managing director of Prager & Company, where he structured more than $1 billion in transactions for colleges and universities. Lloyd is a member of the board of directors of Tuition Plan Consortium, LLC, a nonprofit company which offers the only nationwide prepaid 529 college savings plan. And recently, Lloyd played a key pioneering role in structuring and deploying the first service to offer students transparent comparisons in the $6 billion per year private student loan marketplace. Hi, Lloyd. Welcome to College Smart Radio.
Hi, Beatrice. Good to be here.
Thanks for joining us. Perhaps we can start with a quick explanation of your role in the private loan marketplace. Then we can delve into what the private loan marketplace really is.
Sure. Prager is the program manager for the colleges, universities that refer students to the private loan marketplace. And that means we work with the partner company that actually provides the marketplace. We work on regulatory matters. We work on a variety of things just to make sure it's working well.
And we call it a marketplace because it's literally the store that people go to find loans.
Correct. It's really the only website that presents side by side the specific loan rates and terms that a student would see if they applied to each of the lenders directly.
So how is the marketplace is different than other online private loan comparisons, but you know what? I'm going to wait until we come back after the break to talk a little bit more about explain that differentiation between them, because I know there are some other sites like simpletuition.com that are available. You're with us on College Smart Radio, where my guest today is Lloyd Leance, a managing director of Prager & Company. Lloyd played a key pioneering role in structuring and deploying the private student loan marketplace that we're discussing on today's show. We all know that college is expensive and will most likely be some of the most costly years for a family. And understanding how to navigate the college costs to save everywhere you can is a smart thing to do. We'll be right back with Lloyd Leance on College Smart Radio.
For more information on today's topic, visit collegesmartradio.com or call area code 650-587-1559. College Smart Radio continues in moments on AM 1220 KDOW. Contact Beatrice Schultz at collegesmartradio.com or call area code 650-587-1559. Now, back to College Smart Radio with your host Beatrice Schultz on AM 1220 KDOW.
Welcome back to College Smart Radio, where we help you tackle the runaway costs of college. I'm Beatrice Schultz. I'm talking with my guest, Lloyd Leance, about the private student loan marketplace. Lloyd, we were just talking about the marketplace, and you were going to explain why this website is more accurate, or really the only one that gives accurate information when shopping for student loans.
Sure. All the other sites that say they provide private loan comparisons really don't. If you have ever used a site like Travelocity to buy a plane ticket, you'll understand what I mean. So imagine that you went to Travelocity and what they said to you was, yeah, you know, there are five airlines that fly between LA and Chicago. Their flights leave as early in the morning as 9 and as late in the evening as 10. And their fares range from $99 to $599. You know, there are five of them here. Call them. Call each one. That's what you would have to do if that's the way the Travelocities of the world work. Well, of course they don't. The way Travelocity works is it gives you the exact fare and exact time and for a whole bunch of different choices, and you pick the one, the combination of fare and time that works best for you. The same thing is true of the private loan marketplace and is uniquely true for the private loan marketplace. No other site does it.
I think it's a great analogy because I often laughingly talk with my clients about the fact that they spend more time planning their vacations than they do planning on how they're going to possibly pay for this huge college expense. When we think about the marketplace, so how can you get exact data? How does the process work? How would students find out about it? And how would they apply for a loan through the marketplace?
Well, hopefully what we really want, our favorite idea, is that they find out about the private loan marketplace through the financial aid office at their college, because that would increase the chances that they would have considered all of their other options before they consider a private loan. So once they, so hopefully, again, they find out about it through their financial aid office, they go to the website. Anybody can go to it, but if they find out about it through their financial aid office, that's ideal. Anybody can go, though, to privateloanmarketplace.com, log in, fill in your information. The site will pull your credit and the credit of your cosigner. In general, it's a good idea with private loans, whether they're sourced through the private loan marketplace or not, to have a cosigner. You typically do have more choices and rates and so forth are better. And the marketplace will pull the credit and actually look at the criteria for the participating lenders and tell you what your deal would be, the specific deal would be for those, each of those lenders for you. Saves you an enormous amount of time compared to calling each of those lenders or applying. You'd have to apply to each lender on each lender's website to have the same experience. The Federal Reserve did a study and showed that almost nobody does that. So students are really paying, in general, a lot more than they need to.
I think it's really true. Also, when I look at my students,